300 beds. Kung 10% lang binigay mo, 30 beds lang yan. So, kulang talaga. So, what we're saying now is that kailangan i-adjust na yung bed cover, bed allocation nila para sa COVID. Kasi, crisis to eh. You should understand this is a crisis. Parang hindi na to business as usual.
Yes, sir.
Hindi na natin gagamitin yung mga strategy natin na para nung araw. Iba na to eh. This is COVID. This is already COVID era and post. Well, I don't know when the post COVID era is, but in the COVID era, we have to adjust. Kasi from what failures that we had, we learned before. Kailangan, we have to build on our success this time and making sure na collaborate natin.
Yes, sir. Usec, you've mentioned po earlier about your experiences and your best practices po doon sa southern Philippines. Will you also be implementing that here?
It really depends. Kasi different kasi ang environment. Cebu is totally a tri-city.
Yes.
It has three mayors. You know, so three different LGUs. Davao City is one mayor. So it's a big area, but it's one. So there are actually certain differences. So that's the reason why the strategy there we did in Davao City might not be effective here in Cebu, wherein you have three mayors around. So what we're doing right now is just making sure that the public institutions, mga public, especially Vicente Soto, they will be able to adjust at once there is a crisis na. Hindi na i-limit lang sa 30 to 50%. But parang accordion, something like, I was saying this in a conference hall, you have more guests coming in. So that's a kind of attitude that we must have. And also the public, the private, must also be willing to admit at least 30% when there is a surge. Para claro.
You've mentioned also, Usec, yung low utilization rate ng ating mga isolation facilities.
O, yung mga treatment facilities. Okay. Kasi ayaw naman kasi magpunta yung isang tao doon. Kung walang doktor, kung walang nurse. Anong use? So that's the reason. Kailangan i-formalize ko rin yun eh. Kailangan sa hospital, i-partner mo yun at saka yung temporary facilities. Mm-hmm. Kasi kung iwanan mo yung temporary facilities, na wala kang partner hospital, hindi na mag-aalaga niyan. Some mild may problema, may hypertension, may diabetes, kind of stuff. So this is one reason. We're trying to coordinate, talk to them. Make sure that we will be able to respond to this, learning from our mistakes or failures.
Is there a possibility, Usec, na mag-force tayo ng agreement with our private hospital?
We have to.
Yes. Target po natin.
I will have to talk this out with the regional health office.
Okay.
Because we have to craft the model for this. In principle, it's agreed. No? In principle naman, agreed. Yung mawa-mawa, pang ano lang yun.
Formality.
Formality.
Yes.
It's all agreed. We have to do this. Adjust to the situation because times are not normal.
Opo. Between now and in the coming days po, ano pong mga hakbang nagagawin natin?
So what we're looking into this and then we go to Metro Manila again and CR, try to fix this, possibly look into the possibility of adding more COVID referral institutions.
Yes.
Kasi ngayon, PGH, pag napuno ang PGH, saan na naman natin ito paglalagay? So you need to identify ngayon kung saan natin paglalagay. So you have to come up with a good strategy, especially with Metro Manila and Cebu. Kasi tingnan mo sa geography, sa buong archipelago, sa buong Philippines, ang uptick na sa NCR at sa Cebu. I mean, Mindanao, we're able to control it. Northern Luzon.
Yes, pa.
Dito lang eh.
Okay.
Dito yung NCR at sa Cebu. These are the high economic zones kasi ito.
Assessment mode natin sa referral system and the healthcare system here in Cebu City currently.
The referral system here has to be improved a lot in terms of coordination between public and private and referring from level 1 to level 2. Level 3. And this is the kind of network that we will have to build now. Because without a network of referrals from level 1 and level 2 to level 3, then it becomes kind of hard for a patient to navigate.
Yes.
So and seek for treatment. So I think that's one also isa sa mga ano namin, objective na magkaroon talaga ng referral networks.
Yes.
And parang itong network of mga health facilities within the healthcare provider network.
Mm-mm.
Yun.
Yes, sir. And Usec, may mga visits po tayo today sa hospitals. Scheduled.
Meron kami. Puntahan ko yung Everest Lee. Puntahan ko yung mother yung St. Anthony.
Yes, po.
Kasi yun ang St. Anthony. Gusto ko purely non-COVID ka na. Huwag ka na mag-admit ng mga buntis dyan na may COVID. Tapos
Opo.
Kalahati may non-COVID. Dapat non-COVID ka lang dyan. Stay ka lang. Mayroon Vicente Soto.
Mm-mm.
Para klaro.
Mm-mm.
Yung mga, we'll look into this kasi these are the kind of strategies that we'll do.
So ngayong oras na po kayo pupunta.
After this.